Rudolph.
Rudolph, Donner, Blitzen,
Donner, Blanket, I don't really know the other ones, Prancer, Racer, Cupid, Lust, and Jiminy.
No, Dancer, and Prancer, and Blitzen, and Comet.
Rudolph, Vixen. Blitzen. I don't know.
Dixon and Donner.
Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Vixen, Rudolph.
Sir, sorry to interrupt your date, but we need you guys to keep it down. We're trying to film. Sir. Sir. Maddie, I got you something.
For me?
Sir.
Sir.
Okay.
Congratulations! World's best cup of coffee!
Good morning, Oak Ridge. I'm Maddie Young.
And I'm Vic D'Amatos.
And this
is WENN's Christmas Spectacular. Say, Maddie, have you ever gotten a bad Christmas gift?
Actually, Vic, I think I have.
For shame. Here's Christian Neese on what not to get your friends or family this Christmas.
My name is Christian Neese, and I'm here to tell you about the 10 worst Christmas gifts that, if you get me any of them, will get you disowned and shunned from my life forever. Number one, a Nickelback CD. You have bad taste. Number two, a knockoff lotion kit. Are you trying to make me smell like Lindsay Lohan? Number three, disgusting Walmart perfume or cologne. I don't even need to say anything else. Number four, a Furby. These need to die and go back to 1997. Number five, a car decoration kit. Instant unfollow on Twitter. Number six, party off the pounds with Richard Simmons. What you trying to say? I'm not fat. Number seven, a Justin Bieber picture book. Number eight, a Texan Santa. Okay, I understand the whole bandwagon thing, but this is a little bit much. Number nine, a pickup trucks calendar. This is the kind of thing that you would get from your family that lives in New York. Number 10, a Christmas sweater for my dog.
Well, let's try not to be that guy this Christmas, Oak Ridge.
Well, you know what you should be this year, Vic?
What's that, Maddie?
Generous. Oak Ridge is helping out families this year for Christmas. Here's Shelby Steele with the info.
Hi, I'm Donna Reed. I'm one of the counselors here at Oak Ridge High School, and this is Food Central. We are doing a holiday food collection drive to benefit our students. And once we have everything organized that's been donated, then we complete boxes like this that have a little bit of everything. We have 74 boxes you can't see right now. Surrounding the room, each family will get at least one box and a frozen turkey for their holiday. It started off about 4 or 5 years ago with Ms. Campos, Ms. Berry, and myself. There was a need during the long holidays that people just needed a little extra food. And then it started to be like a basket of cheer for those that maybe are new to the district or had had some health problems in the family. We've even given to people, staff right here, just to show that, hey, we're thinking of you, we love you, you're part of the Oak Ridge family, and we just wanted you to know that. In addition, we have clubs donating money because one day we collected toys. The toys are for CISD elementary children, and they have a shortage, and they've been putting out a cry for help for additional toys and for students who would help wrap the toys. So we're getting financial donations from the clubs to help meet these needs.
It sure is good to see our students doing their part in the community.
Oh, yes it is, Maddie. Speaking of doing your part, here's Reagan Ernst with information about finals next week.
Oh, 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 oh.
As you know, finals week is coming up, so it's time to put those thinking caps on. Tuesday, you go to all your classes, but you take finals in fourth and eighth period. Wednesday, you take your first and third final. Thursday, you take your second and sixth final. And Friday, you're taking your fifth and seventh final. Finals are the most important test of the year, so be sure to take them seriously. And once you're done, be sure to trade in that thinking cap for a Santa hat. Ho ho ho, Oak Ridge.
I got my hat on, Reagan.
I wish I had one too. Like, I wish I had these delicious treats on today's segment of Cooking with Alyssa.
The first Noel the angel did say was to certain.
Hey, Oak Ridge! Welcome to Cooking with Alyssa with your host, Alyssa Allen. Today I'm going to be teaching you how to make Oreo balls. First, you're going to want to start off with a package of cream cheese, Oreos, candy canes, and baking chocolate. Let's get started! First, you're going to want to take a package of Oreos, put them in a plastic bag, and smash them. Now you're going to want to take your crushed Oreos and place them into the mixing bowl. And then you're going to take your cream cheese, which is cut into 1-inch cubes to make the mixing easier. And you're going to blend them together. Now you're going to roll your Oreo mix into balls, and then you're going to freeze it for around 30 minutes. Now you're going to pour the chocolate chips into a bowl and melt them. Now you're going to take your refrigerated Oreo balls and you're going to roll them around in the melted chocolate. And then you're going to sprinkle them with the candy cane.
They're wise men three.
Well, here you go. Hope this tutorial helped you on how to make a holiday treat over the winter break.
Their knee and all.
Fabulous!
Is your voice okay, Maddie?
Well, yeah.
Anyway, hope you enjoyed our Christmas episode, Oak Ridge. I'm Vic D'Amatos.
And I'm Maddie Young.
And that's the way the gift is wrapped.
Happy holidays.
Ding!